Hello again and welcome back to my channel. Finally, I'm getting ready to build up the ultimate gaming PC. To begin with, today I will show you ThermalTake View 51 case, which I still thought was the best option even in 2023, and I will discuss some points regarding airflow and case air pressure system. Let's get into it. The case is really huge and very spacious. Looking at the front, it's dominated by two 200mm ARGB fans installed behind a 4mm thick tempered glass window. Panel is removable and you may change the fans into smaller ones like 120 or 140mm, or you may use a 360mm radiator. All you need to do is removing the bracket to make the installation easier. The I/O consists of a USB-C port, two USB 3, two USB 2, a headphone and mic jack, and a reset button. Now check out the inside of the case. The first thing you see is another 4mm thick tempered glass window, which can be opened easily by twisting the black knob in here. This window is actually removable for easier installation of your hardware components. The case comes with the three included fans, a 120mm rear fan for exhaust and two 200mm in front. This case has a very good graphic card mounting option. You can now choose between a vertical or horizontal GPU mount, but remember you need to purchase a riser cable separately for the vertical mounting. The side mounted case fans can support up to 3 120 or 140mm fans or a 360mm radiator. Looking at the bottom of the case, there are two SSD mounts which are removable, so you could adjust and maneuver them with other spots around the case on the bottom. After removing the mounts, you can choose if you want to put a 3-piece 120mm fan or a 360mm radiator. In case you want to use a radiator, don't forget to use a slim one, not the standard thick type, because the radiator fans will hit the vertical GPU bracket. Underneath the case on the bottom, there is a slide out dust filter which is accessible from the back of the case. At the top of the case, it has the support of 3 120mm, 3 140mm or 2 200mm fans, as well as the same support up to a 360mm radiator. They can sit under a tempered glass panel that's removable. Now moving to the back side of the case, we see a space for 120mm exhaust fan, the motherboard IO shield space, and some other places for hard drives, PCIe slots, and the power supplies. One thing to note, the PCIe slots can actually turn sideways by unscrewing a few screws and remounting. And finally, the right side of the case. The back panel is held by two screws that are easily removed. There are two spaces for dust filters, a space for hard drives, power supply, and all other related cables for system operation. And the last but not the least, the fan hub for the three included fans. You must choose a good airflow system so that your hardware remains at the lowest possible temperature. That's the only way you could actually gain 100% of your system capabilities, since you already know that the heat is your number one enemy when it comes to the system performance. Before starting, let me just tell you about airflow types and the differences. The first one is positive airflow or air pressure. That's when you have more intake fans than exhaust fans. To make it simple, it means more air is coming into your case than exiting. The second one is negative type, which is quite the opposite of the first one. So you have more exhaust fans than intake fans, which creates a slight vacuum as well. The third one is a balance or neutral. That's when you have almost the same number of intakes and exhausts. I will explain briefly how to measure precise amount of your case air pressure, but before that, we need to know a couple of things first. In our case, we are using ThermalTake fans. So each fan, depending on their size and fan blade design, can produce a different amount of airflow, and is measured by cubic feet per minute or CFM to see how many cubic feet of air the fan blade can move within 1 minute. Alright, let's take a look at ThermalTake fan stats here. Based on their test, a 120mm fan has 56 CFM maximum airflow, a 140mm can produce 70 CFM, and a 200mm fan can give you up to 129 CFM maximum airflow. let's just pause for a bit and talk about RMP and CFM to avoid any confusions. Although they are related together, but sometimes at the same speed of rotation or RMP, you can get different airflow results between two fans. For example, if you have a modern angular shaped fan blade, then with the same speed of RMP, you will get more airflow than a standard fan with straight blades. But in general, the more RMP, the more CFM. Okay, going back to our topic, now it's time to measure your case airflow and determine if it's a positive, negative, or a neutral. After knowing your fan's capacity and how much airflow each one can produce, now it's time to add up the total amount of intakes and total amount of exhaust and then do the comparison to get the results. If total CFM intake is more than total exhaust, then you have a positive airflow system, and if it's less, then you have a negative one, which personally I wouldn't be recommending, especially if you are in hot and humid weather areas. And finally, if your total amounts are almost equal, then you have a neutral or a balanced case air pressure. In my case, I'm intending to use a positive type, and I will be building an ultimate gaming PC with the new upcoming AMD Ryzen 7950 X3D CPU combining with all other high-tech hardwares that I'm sharing the video soon. In the end, we run it to test the FPS on different gaming modes and see how it goes. That's it for our today's video, hope you enjoyed it, and see you in the next video. We'll be right back.